Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
We have a topic today, accounting versus engineering. I mean, this is the career option. What is exactly this career option is all about? Well, once students, you know, graduate from the high school, they always get confused about what career to choose. Having so many options make them suffer from analysis to paralysis. I was very much confused on, you know, what should I choose, engineering or commerce, that is accounting. So I finally chose what we call as accounting for my graduation and did my post-graduation majors in finance. So however, it's always better to step back from all the options and make an informed decision about your career. What you choose now will significantly affect who you will become in the years to come. So in this tutorial, I'll try to discuss accounting versus engineering. The students gets overwhelmed by the opportunities and impact of both these careers have on the society and the world at large. But here's a question for you. Do you really think that you are stuck with this two or not able to decide which one you should pick? We will share over here everything about these two careers in this particular tutorial. You will get to know the outlook of these two careers, what sort of education and additional qualifications you require, the primary task you need to perform in these two careers, the work-life balance you would have if you would have chosen to join one of these two careers, and the compensation of both, finally, the pros and cons of this kind of careers. So let's begin. See, to be able to be good at accounting and engineering, you need to be a person who is detailed oriented. You have to be detail oriented. I mean, lovers, numbers, and can be creative enough to think beyond the general conception of the theories. But they are completely different careers. In this tutorial, we'll discuss the perspective of the two careers so that you can get a glimpse of what to expect from each of them. Ask any businessman who they depend upon the most. Yes, you are right, you know, the accountants. Why? Because they know the things about tax, auditing, clauses, company, laws, and moreover, experts in how business works. So the experts in the business always recommend that you should have at least, you should at least know the basics of the accounting. And if you want to go in the business, that's the most basic thing. But if you want to take a career in accounting, it does not need to be boring, as it is, because it's been projected like that. You can do relevant courses on a professional qualifications, and then companies will run after you. So if you are confident enough, you can also do your own accounting practices. And in that case, your business will thrive in like tax seasons and other times. So you need to do some marketing to keep your business all the time high. Now, in case of engineering, you need to be at the top of your game of all the time. So there are new inventions that are coming every year, and you need to update yourself with all such information that are floating around. So now, engineering is a very broad term. There are many specializations in engineering domain. There is computer engineers, there's chemical engineers, there are mechanical engineers, civil engineers, software engineers. But the thing is that, you know, what you should choose if you are curious about the specialization. Well, it depends upon people to people. The accounting versus engineering education. See, accounting versus engineering, it requires different sort of degrees and additional qualification. Let's start with accounting. If you see, with accounting can be called as more of general degrees. But if you pay attention to the top-notch accountants, they are not general accountants. They specify, and for that, best qualification you can go for is CA, Chartered Accountancy. This is the world's second best course, so you can imagine how good it really can be. Know that CA is not for the faint-hearted, absolutely. Now, the pass percentage is 2 to 3%. And you can guess that how tough it is. Only the best gets through. But once you are through, the whole series of possibilities will open up for you. Having a CA degree allows you to start your own accounting practice as well. If you are more interested in, like, you know, it is called as the public accounting, you can think of enrolling yourself into CPA course, which is as good as Chartered Accountancy. But the focus is more on the public enterprise. And it is said that if you become a CPA, join a public enterprise, and your salary would be at least 15% more than non-certified account. You can also go for MBA in this scenario, in finance, and is also an option. But if you do it in finance, the portion of the accounting would be much less. Think about this option and then take a call. I mean, you have tons of options to go for. You need to take a call on that. Engineering is a technical degree. You need to choose which engineering courses you are interested in and then enroll yourself into the same. Like, if you're interested in academics, you can do M.Tech. You can do M.Tech over there. And ultimately, you can do PhD in that particular scenario. But if you are more interested in going for a job, The opportunities are endless. It's said that the computer engineers earn the maximum in the United States after graduating from the courses. So if you are inclined towards computers, you can go for it. Otherwise, chemical engineering, electronic will pay as well in a really good amount. Now, both of these courses require strong math skills and you need to be really good with the calculations. Accuracy over here is the key thing. And according to the survey that was conducted in the Career Bliss in 2012, accounting and engineering both came in the top 20 happiest job. So before you choose anything between both of this, accounting and engineering, know that the work satisfaction is guaranteed. So let's look what are the key roles that you need to play as an accountant and as an engineer. Now, the accountant is always the edge of his seat. So he has to classify, record, maintain accuracy, what is called as, of the accounting statement. So a company has so many transactions on everyday basis. So the primary job of accountant is not the transactions and do corresponding journal ledgers and the trial balance. So that, you know, finally at the end of the year, these transactions can take place in the company balance sheet and the balance sheet can be tallied. And thus the accountant needs what is called accuracy. Think about this. If one transaction gets missed by the accountant and let's say the transaction is few thousand dollars, then how would it affect the balance sheet of the company? Even if the accounting jobs are called boring and routine, it's far from it. Yes, there are definitely some parts that are monotonous, you can say that. But that does not mean that there is no exciting thing about it, accounting. If you do chartered accountancy, your job would be more exciting as you would be having a lot of knowledge and experience in the field of taxation, management, audit, accounting, social auditing, and advanced accounting. Now, in the case of the engineering, there are mainly six functions. One is called the research. This is one of the primary things that you need to do before for you to invent something new using different experimentation technique, applying inductive reasoning and employing mathematical concepts into your research, which would yield you a greater benefit. Then there is a thing called development. Once the engineer research and gathers the information that can be useful, it's time to apply those ideas in the development of the product or a new idea that can help the company. Then there is a part called design. In designing a product or any structure like building or bridge, the engineer designs each and every part of the structure or the product, and it is first done on the paper and then the prototype is being built. Then there is a thing called construction. And now over here, an engineer constructs the building or the structure by following the design crafted by him or by his colleague. And the final is the operations. Engineers who hand machines, equipments, you know, they take care of the overall operations of these machines, and he takes care of the procedures or, you know, supervises the personnel to see whether every part of the machine or equipment is working properly or not. Now, how about the work-life balance? Well, if you become an accountant, you'll be maintaining a great work-life balance. There will be. You will generally be working 40 hours a week and will get enough time for your family to enjoy the hobby like you like. And if you become a CA, your work pressure will increase, but still you will not have a 16 hours a day every day. Rarely do you need to work for 16 hours a day. Now, if you choose engineering, the work-life balance would depend on the specialization you choose, but the job hours are not as much as you would see in case of the investment banker. Thus, an engineer, you can maintain a good work-life balance throughout. And many times engineers want to make career in IBE, investment banking. So, you know, particular topic or is, you know, for them, you know, can an engineer get an investment banking job? Now, seventh, how about the compensation part? Now, here's the most important part, the compensation. So an accountant in USA, they earn closely around $65,940 per annum. The best 10% earns around $115,000 closely. And in case of engineering, the computer engineers, they earn closely around $110,650, software engineer closely $106,050 closely, chemical engineer closely $103,590, electrical engineer $95,780. And so on and so forth goes about. So I hope this difference will surely help you out to decide what exactly is good and what you should go for.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.